We could all use a moment of normalcy, and so you are cordially invited
for a long weekend on my private island.
I like the glass onion as a metaphor.
With a glass onion, you don't need to peel the layers back. You can actually see what's in the middle.
One of the things that was very exciting for me about being able to make the Benoit Blanc mystery is doing a whodunit that's set in modern day that very openly engages with America right here and right now and what we're all talking about.
I hired Gillian Flynn to write the whole thing.
Oh, she's quite good.
She's goddamn expensive, is what she is.
I think one of the things people get most out of going to the movies, even in a mystery, I think if people can feel that it's of their moment, then it has a certain special zest to it.
Look, everybody, look.
What's so brilliant about Rian's writing is, like any good art, you want people to read into it however they decide or choose to. You're creating a dialogue and people want to talk about it.
I want the truth.
It goes deep. It goes a lot of different places. And so that energy allowed us to come into work and give our all.
Glass Onion struck a completely different tone from Knives Out. It was trying a whole new narrative gambit, a whole different setting, new characters. It was just, okay, we're making a new movie and just trying to make it good.
The whole feel of this movie is a little bit bigger.
Wow!
The location is more grand, the costumes are more colorful, the performances are a little bit more heightened.
You have to help me, help me, help me!
What happens at 10 o'clock?
On the other hand, there's never doing that for its own sake. I mean, it's still every shot tells a story. I think a lot of the scope just comes from what the movie actually is, like what's on the page.
Rian's got a great eye for environments that help tell the story that he's trying to tell.
We just wanted to make it something really special, and we wanted to represent this by speaking loudly and giving it such modern, but still keeping that old Hollywood glamour feel.
This score feels a bit bigger than Knives Out. I mean, this one pushes in a few different directions. We're a 70-piece orchestra this time, and we're leaning into that romantic 70s European string sound that I love.
Even though it has a huge ensemble, the first movie, there were only a couple of scenes where the whole cast was together. This film, there is a lot of all the characters hanging out, talking to each other, which is hard to cover with cameras and keep it straight. So there was more math in terms of filming it with this one.
Really, Duke?
Oh my God!
Really?
That support, the sort of the generosity of the people that we're working with was there so that every shot would work. I think that everybody was just keen to make it better.
I've got the predefinite detective in the world at my murder mystery party. That is so legit.
And it's always got to be a fun ride about a character at the heart of it that you're going to care about their plight and you're going to be emotionally satisfied at the end. But at its heart, it's always got to be a ride.
I expected complexity. I expected a puzzle, a game. But that's not what any of this is.
Look into the clear center of this glass onion.